Hello there, welcome back to Let's Play Planescape Torment Blind. I'm the RPG chick. We're here in the Trash Warrens. Just came in, got attacked, killed people. That's about it. Piles of rags are used as beds. Not surprising. Will you get out of my way?
Done.
Dustman embalming charm. And bandages. And junk. There you go. You can hold on to that for me, thank you. This looks like it was part of some more permanent structure, perhaps buried in the surrounding trash. The walls of these trash warrens are made of junk, crushed together by the weight of the mountains of garbage above.
I'm gone.
How charming. Junk.
Done.
Dead endo, huh? Key.
Done.
This looks like it was part of some more permanent structure, perhaps buried in the surrounding trash.
All right.
Oh, crap.
All right.
Good as done.
I'm gone.
They are connecting.
Gone.
Morale failure, running. Come on, finish him off. Thank you. I'm getting 120 XP for these guys.
Alright.
Okie dokie. Buried villager. Try talking. Now we try talking. Ow. Too many. A spell here for Rain of Anger.
I'm hurt.
Yeah, you are. Going through these. Wait a second, did I really take that? Apparently. You know what? I think I used the wrong character. I can't believe that. Heal him, thank you.
I'm hurt.
Yeah, these guys hit hard. Holy crap.
Endure. In enduring growth.
Good as done.
I hear your words. Your path is mine.
Excellent. Is it the buried villagers that are so tough? They really hit hard.
I will hear you. Your path is mine.
Okay.
Too late to run. Wow. Some battle. Lots of copper. That was a big fight there.
Your will be done.
Sounds good to me. Alright. Don't mind saving now. Just in case. More. Why do I have to keep fighting these people?
All right.
Oh, there's another portal. That's easy.
I'm gone. All right.
All right. Before we go into that, we'll look around the rest of this place.
I'm gone. All right.
Hello, Bish. These guys aren't gonna fight. Let's talk to Bish. As you enter the room, a large, heavy-set man gets up from his chair and approaches you. Hello there, name's Bish. Who might you be? I have no name. What do you mean you don't have a name? You just come back from sticks swimming, you clueless sod? You notice Bish slowly moving his hand towards his weapon. Or are you just not telling me? hiding something, methinks. Might pacify him by lying. Give him a name just so he just calms down, maybe. I was told I could locate Pharod around these parts. Sweet. Fish eyes you suspiciously. Pharod usually fills me in on visitors, and I don't recall the likes of you being mentioned. He quickly glances you over before giving you an apathetic shrug. Eh, you don't look like anything the guards couldn't handle. On with you. Farewell. The man looks up slowly as you approach. A trash warren's thug. He takes a look at you and sneers in disgust. What in the nine hells you be? Be ya, whatever. He wrinkles his nose. Mayhap the Dusties are missing one of their rotting dogs. He laughs. Ha! Never have I seen anything so ugly. Do we dare? Accept your reflection? The man seems taken aback for a moment, then sneers again, fingering the hilt of his blade. You look due for a bleeding, Governor. Settle down. I have no interest in fighting you. Oh, you don't, do you? He spits at your feet. What, does the thin, watery blood of cowards fill your veins, Berg? Or did you all seep out during your last mangling? Alright, we're gonna say this. As I recall, your mother is the one who has the thin, watery blood of cowards running in her veins. By my count, that means half the city's bastards carrying the same bloodline as you. The man blinks for a moment, as if digesting what you said. Then his face flushes with anger. He draws his blade and lunges at you. Ah, let's go defend ourselves.
I'm gone.
No, I'll be gone yet.
Balance in all things.
Aye. Litany of curses at Bish.
Well, I'm gone. I felt her. I'm hurt.
Yeah. Seamstress's house. Marta? Hold on.
What is your will?
Alright, never mind. You see a blockish woman dressed in heavy burlap robe. She lumbers about the room, her joints popping as she bends over to pick up objects from the various tables. Her hair is bound back from her head with a bone hairpin, and she has a sour, curd-faced expression. She is mumbling to herself in a sing-song voice. Greetings. The woman doesn't appear to hear you. Instead, she stumbles back to one of the long tables and begins picking at one of the corpses. Come on now, she clicks her teeth. Don't be all difficult on Marta. He's being difficult, isn't he, Marta? Yes, yes, he is. Just watch what she's doing. From what you can see, it looks like she's digging teeth out of the corpse's mouth. with only her hands and fingernails. When that doesn't work, she pulls out a splintered wooden chisel and a mallet and thwacks at the gums until the tooth snaps free. She puts it into a bag at her waist. What are you doing? Marta leaps away from the corpse, startled, and gives a piercing shriek. Aye! She clutches her breath and then hisses angrily at the corpse on the table. If dead you were not, you might have said something earlier. False corpse, nasty corpse, yes? Have you no shame? Throw my voice. Let's throw our voice. You are the one who should be shamed, knocking out my teeth like that. Have you no respect for the dead? Ha! Marta puts her hands on her hips and puffs up indignantly. Like she cared for your teeth, all rotted and scored and syrup brown. Wonder they's hadn't popped out of your bone box. She scratches her head. Isn't that right, Marta? All rotten gone they are. Throw a voice. Ooh, you will be punished for your evil teeth talking, Marta. I shall haunt you until the end of your days. Ha! You see as this, Marta? Do yous? Marta's face scrunches up like a wrung rag. I hears it, Marta. I hears it. Okay, there's two of her in there. With a grunt, she starts pounding the corpse with her fists, making meaty thwacks with every hint. Haunt me, will you? Take this. And this. Throw a voice. Ooh, stop. Stop. I will haunt you no longer. Forgive me. Damnable debtors. Marta takes a deep breath and lets the chisel fall to her side. That's more like it, eh, Marta? Yes, yes. Corpse quiet. Yes. I am the one who spoke, not the corpse. Marta squints and turns. Eh? How'd you get over there so fastest? She mumbles to herself. Marta, how did you do that? No glimmer. Mort says, this grave bathes blind and near deaf. Marta is still mumbling to herself, something about corpses and gratitude, which you don't quite catch. Who are you?
Updated my journal.
Marta, did this one ask who I was? Aye, he did. She starts humming, nobody but mine. I am Marta, Marta the seamstress. Marta the seamstress. She turns back to the corpse, singing her name to herself. What are you doing? Marta turns back to the corpse with a huff. I'm trying to get this Burke to give up his stitchies and his teethies, and he isn't recuperating. No. She wags her finger, as if lecturing a small child. Stubborn as stone, isn't he, Marta? She pouts. Yes, he is. Stitchies and teethies? What are you talking about? Gotta pull the stitchies out. The teethies. Eh, Marta, perhaps you can give me a hand? I have been giving you a hand, old baddie. No need to take that tone with me. Putting out the stitches and teethies, yes. And the thingies inside. Thingies inside. I think she means organs, Mort says. I hope she means organs. Marta says, thingies. Mort turns to Marta. Yes, thingies. He then turns to you. It's all semantics. Marta, why are you pulling out the corpse teeth and stitches?
Updated my journal.
Put them aside, Marta. That's what I does here. She scratches her head. Aye, Marta, we do. Stitchy thread and teethies are precious. Can be turned into jink-jink. Strip the corpse as we bring you. They tell Marta. Pull out teethies, stitchies, thingies inside corpse. Strip them cold, and then we sell them to the dusties. Sell the corpses to the dusties? Tells you to do this when you're looking around the body. Marta frowns. Did we not say we'd be selling them, Marta? Her frown deepens, and she shakes her head. Aye, Marta, we did. Dusties buy bodies, but we takes all we can at first. Who tells you to strip the corpses? Fat-faced gimme pig Quint, and the other crutch hobble. Hobble crutch. Pharod. It right, Marta. She gives a queer smile and nods. Aye, it is, Marta. I'll get to Pharod. What do they do with the things you dig out of the corpses? Sell for shinies. I see. Can I ask you some other questions? Did the one say questions, Marta? Marta blinks and frowns. Aye, Marta, he said such, for he wears the asking look on him, he does. I want to ask about Farah, though. What do you find in the bodies? Thingies. She gives a lopsided shrug. The others take them. Who? Yeah, okay. Pharod, where is he? Marta shrugs. Where's Pharod? This one asks. He's here, Marta, isn't he? She nods. Aye, Pharod is here, Marta. One of the buildings here he is. Can you dig in my body to find anything? Marta squints at you. Then nods. Marta can do that. Can't you, Marta? Yes, she can. Mort says, I am not going to watch this. Marta says, where? Where? Marta is studying you as if looking for the best place to crack you open. Oh, this is interesting. Let's try the stomach, shall we? You lie upon a table and Marta stands over you, a rusty knife at the ready. Great. There is a stabbing pain as she slices into your abdomen, then cuts brutally downwards in a saw-like motion, exposing your innards. Despite the pain, you watch in morbid fascination as he lifts up your stomach. Your vision slowly returns to see Marta standing over you, shaking her head. Nothing. Nothing found. Marta? She shakes her head. No, nothing, Marta. No luck. Should we try again? How about my rib cage? You lie upon a table and Marta stands over you, a chisel and mallet at the ready. There's a sharp crack as she splits your rib cage open, and you choke back your screams as she begins to fish in your lungs. As you try and gasp for air, you go numb, then black out from the pain. Fall into darkness. Yeah, nothing again.
Check the intestines.
Check the intestines. Anything can be lodged in there. You lie upon a table and Marta stands over you, a rusty knife at the ready. There's a stabbing pain as she slices into your abdomen, then cuts brutally downwards in a saw-like motion, exposing your innards. Despite the pain, you watch in silent, morbid fascination as she plunders your organs, humming to herself. Ah! There's a retching pain as Marta lifts up the ropey mass of your intestines, blood and other fluids streaming from it. Look at this, Marta. Look at this. I see. Cut there. Marta makes a small, deft incision in the side of one of the intestines, and you hear a ting as something small and metallic strikes the floor.
Updated my journal.
Marta then dumps the soupy mass back into your torso, then reaches down, picks up the object, a ring, it appears, and she flicks it to you. Pretty, eh, Marta? She nods. Yes, Marta. One shouldn't swallow such a thing. No. Thanks. Was there anything else? Marta shakes her head. Nothing more. More nothing, eh, Marta? Should we try someplace else, Marta? How are we coming back to life after all this crap? Crack open my skull, if you would. You lie upon a table, and the last thing you see is Marta standing over you, chisel and mallet at the ready. There's a sharp crack, and you scream as everything goes black.
Updated my journal.
Your vision slowly returns to see Marta standing over you, shaking her head. Nothing found, eh, Marta? I have some other questions. You pull stitches out of corpses. Can I buy some needle and thread from you? She seems confused. Buy? Jink, jink? Ain't you here to pick some up? That's what you're here for, ain't you? To pick up the thread, bones, rattling teethies? Yeah, I'm here to pick them up.
I couldn't carry any more, so I had to drop it.
Here's what you came for. She passes the items over to you. All I have. Thanks. I had some other questions. Yeah, no questions. I must take my leave. Farewell. Now we dropped a whole bunch of crap.
Yeah.
Teeth. Needle and thread.
Okay.
These teeth appear to be a set of hollow fangs. The tips of the teeth are wet and drip a viscous fluid. 2 to 7 piercing, usable only by Mord, of course. I have to identify those then. I thought that we should have identify. Maybe he has to be carrying it himself. I think he does actually. Eh? Teeth of the Viper. Enchanted +1. Poison's target. Immunity to poison. These teeth appear to be a set of hollow fangs, much like those of a viper. Although long removed from the original host, the teeth still drip poison from their sharp lip... Sorry, tips. Sharp lips. Alright, 2 to 7... 1 to 6... These are badder.
Hey, come on. Hey.
Oh, we made all the needle and thread separate, that's why. Wonder I couldn't carry it all. I mean, come on. Intestines! This ropey mass of bloody intestines appears to be yours. You have to admit it makes you uncomfortable to see them outside of your body. Twisted ring. This ring looks like 3 rings that have been wrapped around each other. Just looking at it makes you dizzy. So we'll start looking around then. This tub is filled with a mess of rotting body parts. They all look picked clean.
Done.
1 needle and thread. Okay. This is a pile of foul-smelling body parts. Arms, legs, torsos, even the occasional head. They all look picked clean.
I'm gone. Done.
So, Seamstress's house. So we still in the trash warrens? How do I get out of this place? Ah. Buried village. Alright. Buried villager. Well, at least these aren't attacking. You see a ragged man clad in patchwork clothes. He reeks of smoke and trash and has a yellowish cast to his skin. He looks askew at you. What do you want from me, Cutter? Just to answer some questions. Make it fast, Cutter. I got mouths to feed. Who are you? Ain't important, Cutter. Slipped twixt the cracks too long ago. Or maybe that was me da. One way or another, I'm just another one trying to make a living any way I can. What are you doing? Trying to make a living. What's it look like? Only I keep getting asked questions. It's stopping me from doing that. You done yet? For now. It looks like someone parked this cart here long ago. Buried village. It's funny, it shows up as explored. But I did not explore this yet. Quint? Oh, Quint Shop, that's what she mentioned Entrance to Pharod's court. Gateway to the Weeping Stone Catacombs. Stairs leading up to the Trash Warrens. Alright. Guess what we'll do is we'll look around this area and we'll backtrack out the Trash Warrens. See if there's anything else there. And then we'll go to Pharod's court. Sounds good to me. Maybe people won't attack us endlessly here. Village thug. Okay, let's stay away from them then.
Alright.
Raideen. Oh, crap. Never mind. Guys won't let me through to get the stuff. Raideen. Stop, Raideen. This woman has returned to her faraway stare, but her mind has not wandered as far this time. She's not nearly as startled by you. You again, eh? What'd she say last time? Oh. You see a woman with a lined face and drab clothing. Her eyes are far away, and there seems to be a new vitality rising up from her skin. As if she'd been given a new life. There's a patterned tattoo around her neck. She starts when you speak to her. I have some questions for you. Mayhap I got answers for you. Mayhap I don't. Tell me about yourself. Me? I got two names now, and I'll show you only one. Don't want you stealing a new one. You can call me Raideen, pet. And I'll hold this other name tight to myself, I will. Two names, huh? Must be nice to have them. Aye, Poppet, it is. Can you give me some other answers? Tell me about this place. The buried village? Nice enough place, I suppose, if you don't mind the stench of corpses being torn open, garbage heaped on the roof, and the constant scurrying of rats around here. Much colder with only a name and no number to protect you, that's for sure. Tell me about your name. Alright, never mind. Same thing. Tell me about the number. This squirmy thing? It's an identifying number. It's my number, given to me by a kind man who saw me cold without the protection of numbers to back me up. Now I got it, and I'm happier than I've ever been before. Interesting. How's it work? Safety in numbers. And with safety comes warmth, and with warmth comes comfort. Numbers can do it all for you, dearie, as long as you respect their power. Tell me about that tattoo. Oh, the tattoo is the number. Alright. I see. Farewell. Look at the way that one walks. Walks all messed up. See that? Should we talk to this one? You see a haggard woman, her care-lined face showing every scar the years have left upon her. Her eyes are knowing and tired, and she sniffles as she speaks. What is it you want from me? Pretty much the same thing. Who am I? She laughs bitterly. Might as well ask for a grain of sand's name, Cutter. That's about as important as I am. That's an uplifting viewpoint. Well, not everyone walks like that. I can't ask you about that, though. Who here? This sour-faced, middle-aged man starts when you approach him and reaches for his belt. Finding no weapon there, he simply backs away from you. You can see that beneath his collector's robes, his lower legs and forearms are swathed in filth-encrusted bandages. What you want? He answers to some questions. He nods but says nothing. Who are you? Name's Uhir, so it is. He spits, as if it mattered down here. What are you doing? Waiting for my wounds to heal up so as I can make another run down below. I sell the stuff I found down here. Down there. down below. He nods his head. Down in the catacombs, where all the debtors is. Say, you going down there any time? Perhaps. Why? Because I lost my lucky knife. He grunts angrily, stomping his foot. He's been with me for years, right here. He points to an empty sheath on his belt. So what happened to it? I was poking about in the catacombs below and ran smack into a ghoul. Must have been a straggler, because there's usually more than one. He bit at me face, so as I covered up with my arms and stabbed it in the eyes, it dropped and bit me at the leg for a while before I shaked the piker off and made it back up here. Quite a story. I'll bring back your knife if I see it down there.
Updated my journal.
Would you? I'd be grateful, so I would. It's got my name carved into the handle. You're covered in bandages. What happened to you? Well, I got bit up a bit by a ghoul down below while I was looking about for stuff to sell off. Alright, farewell. Alright, gonna go for now, guys. Thanks for watching, see you next time, and a bang bang boogie, and don't stop the boogie.
I don't trust the gift.